Fair use disclaimer.
Blah, blah, blah.
Again with the fair use disclaimer. Not sure why anyone puts this here. It does nothing. If the video is copyrighted with the U.S. government and it is not fair use, this disclaimer will not stop the lawsuit. End of story. Okay, today's troll video comes to us from Fraud News Network. How original. In this video, he, she, or whatever it is, they did not give their proper pronoun, so we'll go with it, tells us what he thinks is going on. And as always, like clockwork, it lies about what it is actually happening. The thing is with this video is you see exactly what is happening right in front of your eyes. And this bear ignores it and just lies all the way through. Don't believe me? Just watch. Let's get started.
Hey everyone, this is Sean with And Able Art. So this is not my typical type of video.
Okay, in full transparency, before we move on, this is not how this bear sounds. I have changed the pitch due to the unbearable, see what I did there, sound that was coming out of its mouth. This is what it sounded like. You can thank me later.
What do you mean by choosing to fraud it now?
Maybe that means this will get some views.
Okay, so you're doing it for the views. Well, that's an honest response at least. So, tell me please why you chose frauditing to get your views.
Like a good little capitalist, I took the opportunity presented by Montana Fair, my state fair, to do a little shameless self-promotion by heading to the county fairgrounds with a sign and some flyers to tell people, hey, I'm an artist. I make art and things with art. Trademark. Thing is, the powers that be down there seem to have a little issue with the First Amendment, as they tried really, really hard to run me off, even threatening me with arrest for telling people about pet portraits and silly drawings.
Okay, well, that seems a bit far-fetched. I'm not trying to accuse you of lying, but it seems like you are only giving us a partial story. I'm sure there has to be more to it than the police just didn't like you talking about pet photos, so they tried to run you off. I can see that you will make a great frauditor already. Okay, so let's move on. Tell us about the video we are about to watch.
This clip is of the second time in less than an hour that two sheriff deputies approached me about my free speech. Of note would be the female officer's behavior pretty much throughout the whole encounter. You'll see she makes a face when I ask for her badge number, accuses me of accosting people, makes another face when I bring up my right to be there, rewrites history with her addition of out of the blue in my cops shoot people bit, and FYI, cops shoot people.
Well, cops shoot people is such a blanket statement. Are you really saying that cops just shoot all people?
OMG, that's not what he said. And with that, I'm sorry you had to listen to that. But I had to set this up, and as you can see where this Ted wannabe is heading, you can already tell by the twisting of his words and putting words in his mouth that this is not going to end well for the troll. Let's just get into the video.
So, can I get your name and badge number?
Valerie
Jewel. Badge number, please.
334, that's my badge number. Okay. Call
you, sir?
Edder, 393.
Okay.
So, just... so we're clear, just kind of stay out of the pathway, everybody, and, you know, keep handing out your flyers and have a good time.
Okay.
You can't accost people when you can't.
Did somebody report that I accosted somebody? And what would accosting entail?
Harassing.
So I'm just standing here asking people if they want a flyer. If they don't want a flyer, they don't take a flyer. It's not that, I don't understand the big deal.
Usually you have to have some type of business license to be here, which is kind of odd.
Do you have some evidence that I don't have a business license?
Do you have one?
Do you have some evidence that I don't have one?
Do you have one you can provide?
Well, that was just stupid. It's up to you to prove that you have a business license. It's not up to them to prove you don't. Just like in a criminal trial, the prosecutor has to prove that you committed the crime. You don't have to prove that you didn't commit the crime.
Oh man, this is pure doublespeak troll gold. This is one of the dumbest things I have ever heard. Listen carefully to what the bear said. The bear literally says the cops, i.e. the state, does not have to prove he does not have a business license. The bear then gives this example and says, in a criminal trial, it's up to the state, i.e. the cops, to prove you had committed a crime, not the defendant. Oh, brother. Besides, no one carries a business license with them, and one does not need a business license to exercise their First Amendment rights. These cops are just fishing for a reason to cause trouble and harass him. Why am I surprised? And they have no proof that he is harassing anyone. Why didn't they just stand off to the side, observe him, to prove that he was harassing people? Well, we know why they didn't do that, because he wasn't harassing anybody.
Now, I use the criminal trial as an example because if you decide to keep accidentally frauditing, it's only a matter of time before you will be the defendant in one.
Yes, and if he is a defendant in one, in a trial, who would it be up to prove that he did not have a business license, or he was harassing people, or breaking a law, or any other crime, him or the state? I ask because you don't seem to be too sure about that after that last comment. I'll give you time to figure it out. Before we go on, let me apologize in advance. This next segment is a little disjointed due to the order the troll responded to the video. But let's press ahead.
Yeah, I don't answer questions.
So, just please stay out of people's way.
And what did you say cops do?
I said the police. I asked you. I told you I was going into my pocket to get my phone, and I didn't want you to shoot me
because
police shoot people.
Just out of the blue. That's what you said.
I didn't say just out of the blue. I said police shoot people.
That's what cops do. So impeding the walkway, people walking in and out of a place gets to disorderly conduct, and then if we get there, I'll ask you to leave, and then if you fail to leave, it's disorderly persons failing to disperse, and then we get to the point where you get a citation. You make it leave. Okay. So I don't want to get anywhere.
So this cop is threatening Sean with charging him with disorderly conduct. But there's one problem. He is not doing anything that falls under that statute. In fact, reading over this, I only see one section that could apply to Sean under this disorderly statute. And that is Section 5. By the way, I did not write this. I am quoting the statute as written. Here it is. Rendering the free ingress or egress to public or private places impassable. Is he doing that? Unless he is standing at a turnstile where only one person can enter at a time, how could he be charged with that? But considering where he is and there are no turnstiles to get into the fair, it would be impossible to charge him with that. By the way, cops lie all the time, just like this one is doing, by threatening him with a law that does not apply to what he is doing. But this troll is fine with cops lying as long as they can harass people.
That's because, according to the frauditor, you just want to shoot people. You don't want to deal with all the nonsense that comes before it. You just want to get straight to the shooting.
Oh man, this bear is a bootlicker with a capital B. Remember where I said it does nothing but lie the whole video? Here's another example. Nowhere did Sean say what the cops said he said, that cops shoot all people, and yet here is the bear parroting what the cops said. What Sean said was cops do shoot people. You know, like the kid minding his own business in a McDonald's parking lot where the cop shot at him 10 times. By the way, this time he did get fired.
Get out of the car. Shots fired.
Or how about this one? Where a cop pulls over someone, he gets out and says, "Have your license, please." And the guy goes to get it and he starts shooting at him. So yeah, it can be perilous to reach for something.
Get your license, please. Get out of the car! Get out of the car! Get on the ground!
I just got my license. You can't get my license. I've got the license right here. That's my license right there.
Put your hands behind your back.
What
your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back.
What did I do, sir?
Are you hit?
I think so. I can't feel my leg. I don't know what happened. I just grabbed my leg.
Brakes on A66. I need a 1052.
Just please don't impede people's movement in there. And we won't have any problems, okay?
Well, I mean, it seems like you guys have a problem.
Do you have any questions for me?
No.
We're getting legitimate complaints. We're not just out here harassing you. These are actually legitimate complaints coming in from people.
From people that work here?
No, from people that are entering the fair.
Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I have a First Amendment right to be here.
I had the same look on my face when I heard what he said. I'm trying to find in the First Amendment where it says everyone has a right to be anywhere they want, and while there, shove flyers in people's faces. Maybe I just missed it. Maybe it's in another amendment. Maybe the Third Amendment. I'll keep looking.
I'm trying to find in the First Amendment where you are allowed to come onto the internet and lie about what other people say or do. Even though it doesn't say it, you are allowed to do it under the First Amendment. And yet here you are. As far as that cop and that dumb look, that is because she is about as educated as you are. That's why she made that look. She has no clue. But you can keep on looking for that right, because you wouldn't recognize his rights to do what he is doing if it came out and bit you in the ass.
This is free speech. This is a public forum.
We're not saying you can't.
Okay, and I'm telling you, I haven't moved more than a foot off of this divide.
Wonderful.
Right here.
I have a sneaking suspicion you're not going to want to give me your name.
Why would I give you my name?
Okay.
You want a flyer? I mean, all my info is right there.
What are you doing? You just got in trouble for shoving flyers in people's faces, and now you're trying to shove one on the officer? I don't know if that's dedication or stupidity.
You want a flyer? I mean, all my info is right there. You want a flyer? I mean, all my info is right there. You want a flyer? I mean, all my info is right there.
Okay, show me exactly what part of the video where this guy is shoving this flyer at the police officer. I'm not seeing it anywhere. That's just called handing out a flyer. But your definition of most things is completely different than what most people think.
Dick, the first lady told me I was a white male Republican.
I didn't call you any of those things, though, did I?
I didn't say that you did.
I haven't been rude to you.
I didn't say that you were.
See, there you go. That's all just good interactions. So, do you have any questions for me?
No.
All right, man. Have a good rest of your night, okay?
Okay.
Nothing. Pleasantries back. Have a nice night. You too, sir.
I'm sorry. Do you need a hug? I can give you a hug.
That was awesome.
So, folks, I've had enough of this lying, talking troll bear, but I do have to respond to what was said at the end. The bear made several comments about what happened in Sean's second video that the bear showed at the end of this video. And that was a load of crap. One problem, the bear only played about 2 minutes of the 6 to 7 minute video. And that's because what it called a load of crap happened in full color on the video. I have provided the link below in the comments section. This is my fifth video, and so far this troll's video is by a big margin the most dishonest one yet. But trolls are going to troll and lie. Thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe and spread the word.